I don't inspire to be anyone. I inspire to be the best person possible.
Yeah, but you always have to have
from people that I enjoy watching to create the best person that I can possibly be. And maybe people will want to inspire to be me. But I don't suggest anyone to inspire to be me. Inspire to be the best version of yourself. So I inspire to be Ethan Crow.
Yeah, but it's the same thing working out.
The greatest feeling you can get in a gym, or the most satisfying feeling you can get in the gym, is the pump.
When you aspire to have some guy, you have a goal.
I aspire to have the best physique that my body can physically have. To so look the best.
I aspire whatever.
What about you?
What you said.
Boom.
Alright, who see as a, I don't know if it's a role model is the word, or somebody like not a hero.
I don't know, I don't want to be like anyone, Will.
No?
I just pick and pull from the people that are all great, right, or what they're doing, and I implement it.
Alright, yeah, that's what everybody does, but let me tell you this, what separates the hero from the superhero, like me, if I look up to somebody, I want that person to be, in shape, have style, have great ethics, obviously successful in whatever field. Real estate is my shit, so real estate. And by successful, I mean not only with money, but with fame or status in their social group, and then some. More than the average, I want to say. What else? Somebody that's not afraid to fucking say what they believe. No sugarcoating, says the truth. Comes from nothing, has self-made everything.
Sounds like fucking willpower.
Exactly, so that's somebody like me. Not to sound cocky or anything, but all those is like what Andrew Tate, all the characteristic, you know.
You're a f***ing crypto nerd. You don't got pussy. I got looks, network, and status. That trinity, no yacht billionaires comparing to me. That's why the girls are
of a high value man.
But look what he has. He has the trinity. When has a woman ever dated a man out of the trinity? No, you need that Holy Spirit, right?
So, for instance, I don't, like, Andrew Tate is all cool, whatever, this and that, but looks-wise, I don't think he's not an ugly or whatever, but I wouldn't want to look like him. Not my style. There we go, that's not my style. I'm more like, as you guys can see, fucking Dan Bilzerian.
He's a smarter man than me. Smarter man than me. The picture, he knows better.
Si tengo mucha novia. Muchas novias, hoy tengo a una, mañana a otra. Me la voy a llevar a todas con VIP, un VIP. Hey, saludos.
I think he's got style, whatever. I do like Andrew Tate's wardrobe.
This square scarf adds personality and sophistication to Tristan's outfits. He doesn't overdo it with accessories in general, but you always find him wearing an expensive Rolex watch. Kinda typical for most of the rich men.
Pretty pimp, him and Tristan, they do have a good wardrobe, but like his look, that bald head and that little, he's got that pit bull look going for him, not really my style.
And I tell him, man, hey, you don't want to be a follower, and who cares if they like you or not? What you want to be is a leader and unique. Leaders make a difference. Leaders are the ones that take risks.
But we all have celebrities like that we look up to that have characteristics that we like. Like role model wise, there's, you know, Gary Vee, Grant Cardone, Patrick McDavid, obviously Andrew Tate, Manny Cashman, Tarek Lamouche, all all those guys that are in real estate, whatever, their business ethics, they're people that I look up to, family men, role models. But I can't pinpoint where they told me, oh, you can only be one. Like, which one? I know I've gotten before that I look a little like, when I don't have the beard, that I look like Grant Cardone. So I guess maybe he's the, out of all those guys that I mentioned. Fuck, I was going to the car wash. Oh, fuck that shit, dog. Do whatever the fuck I want. Right here. You gotta do what you gotta do, dog. Escape the Matrix. What else? I don't know what I was going with that. What I was trying to say is basically like a complete package. Like somebody like, damn, I wish I had that guy's fucking physique. I wish I had that guy's money. I wish I fucking had that guy's social status. I wish I had that guy's car. That's another thing. A lot of people have money, but they got no fucking style. Like somebody that like, damn, I wish I had that guy's car, watch, like the style, like pimp, whatever, like that money. So like that, I haven't like met like, like I said, only those celebrities, whatever, those role models. But like in real life, I haven't, I met people, yeah, with money, this and that. But like somebody like, damn, that I want to be like that guy, yeah, that's like, that's the, where I want to be. There's only one person that I can say and I humble down to, whatever, that I aspire to be like, comes from rags to riches, comes from rags to riches. I got the story. Good taste on the watches, the cars, the trips, the lifestyle, family man, business owner, where I want to get into the multifamily fucking commercial of real estate. And that person is Ed Bolden. That guy is fucking the G, the top G, Bolden Ed Bolden. Blue. Yeah, the G putting his name all over buildings. I saw that guy comes from rags to riches, throwing shout out to his parents. For his legacy, no shame in the game. Every time he, every milestone he succeeded, always flaunting, always flexing, but a positive flex. Flexing, if you can do it, if he can do it, you can do it. Right here, Ed, you can do it, I can do it. I'm right behind you, man. I'm following your footsteps, buddy. Every time, bro, we're gonna be partying sometime in some yacht in Miami. Life is good.
What's today, Will? Today is July 13th, 2023. So then we can take this video and implement it right before our party montage with Ed Bolden.
Yeah, but
we're drinking the Ace of Spades because that's what that guy likes, man. Ace of fucking Spades.
There you go, dog.
Ace of Spades, bro. I'll have to try that. We'll go get it one day.
One day. So, yeah. That's the kind of guy and I would like in my circle. That's the kind of person. Like I tell this guy, bro, money only amplifies that. The proof is in the pudding. Just go down my IG. Whatever you see, just amplify that with money. So with that being said, Ed Bolden, much, much more success to you and many blessings. Oh, another thing too with this guy that we were talking about is, bro, we're not, I'm not a contractor. I've said this a million times, and I want to emphasize more on it. Not a contractor, not being a wholesaler. We got a big picture, yeah. Let everybody think that we're doing what everybody is doing. We're gonna get into development, this and that. The only thing is, don't worry about the details. And the story I want to tell you about that is when I was doing my racetrack in Nicaragua, drifting. Oh, that's going about new ideas, bro. I was the first one in Nicaragua. Not only that, I was bringing the racetrack, but I did the first solo event. That's like autocross. I was the first one to do, I was going to bring a drifting event, and the fucking government shut it down. All proof of all that shit. I got the flyers, whatever. But anyhow, when I was doing the racetrack, since I was bringing drift into the country, my ex-wife, shout out, told me, don't trust these. I had a meeting with the mayor of Managua, the capital of Nicaragua. She told me, don't trust those people. Don't give them all your ideas. So anyhow, I had a circle, a roundabout in my racetrack that was going to be for drifting. I told those fuckers it was going to be for marathon of running and racing and bicycling skateboarding, all that shit, but nothing to do with cars or motorcycles or anything. The shit never went through, whatever. Weeks later, the government group, the Sandinistas that were fucking against me, that wanted to steal that project from me, came out because the government that was running the city hall was part of that branch of whatever government. He came out in the news media saying that he was gonna do the racetrack, this and that, and he had that circle, he had a racetrack, because it was gonna have that roundabout for that, for the bicycling, whatever. And I was like, bro, if I would have said the drifting, because another shit too, that I have clips of that, when I did the first solo cross event, that motherfucker, after I did it, came out in one of the news media saying that he had done the first solo cross. That's how the shit worked over there, dog. So we were always in all the news media going back and forth, dog, and whatever. So anyhow, that's why I never give all the details. You can say what you're doing, that I know, many blessings. You can, if I can do it, you can do it. But the details, that's what they discover later on. Boom, boom, boom. Everything what I'm doing right now, I'm setting it up for the big picture. And that shit ain't happening overnight. It takes 10 years to be an overnight success. We already got a 10-year head start. 10-year start in knowledge. Now we're focused with a purpose. Unfucking stoppable.
Mika Speed. Mika,
yeah. That's the motherfucker. I jacked up Gallo. Mika Speed. I was the one that gave that name to it, whatever, that's on the whole different story. But anyhow, they were Nika Speed and I was Speed Fest. And then my racetrack, I was doing it with the NRA, which was the Nicaraguan Racing Association. That was the LLC that I was.
Hey, they posted Speed Fest though.
Oh shit.
It's on Google.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, I thought it was on Nika Speed. I was like, what the fuck?
It's on their Facebook.
What?
Yeah, they posted the thing.
What? That's fucking hilarious. That's the DVD.
Yeah.
That I had.
Yeah, this is in the PlayStation.
Shit. So anyhow, I tell this kid, bro, I did this shit already in Nicaragua. I think I'm just joking around. But we're gonna be famous. What did my daughter Melissa, what did she tell you?
She said, I was talking to her about Nicaragua and she was like, my dad's famous over here. You should come. I said, bets. I'm on my way.
Yeah, buddy. So I know I could say I have a little credibility in knowing what the fuck I'm doing. And if you get to the core of the message of what I'm saying, preaching, bro, the message is positive. And this kid right here is going to be the proof in the pudding. Everybody's already fucking taking notice and seeing and telling you. Don't take my word for it. The proof is in the pudding, dog. Fucking taking over 2024, 2025, 2026.
Bro,
I don't know how this guy doesn't get hyped up, dog. Fuck everything. All right. We're back. The phone's overheating. I don't know. It's 88 degrees in Atlanta.
It's hot as fuck, bro.
Yeah, buddy. And as I was saying, I don't know how this kid doesn't get hyped up, bro. I'm hyped up, bro. Oh, shit's gonna go bad. All right.
Peace.
That car wash. All right, we're leaving the car wash, heading over to Home Depot, then to Project Pains. So going back to where we were at before, with this kid, dog, believe in him.
He is the one.
I'm not gonna put anything in his plate that he can't handle. As he grows, as I was telling him in the email, as he grows, the more shit I throw in his plate. I don't want him to think that I'm just sitting there being lazy, not doing shit. I was like, bro, I've already put it 10 years. I'm trying to cramp as much as possible in you to get to those millions as quick as possible. So I'm just watching from the far, paying attention, not only to what you're doing, everything, but you know, everything has to do with life, your business ethics, how you carry yourself, how you talk to people, blah, blah, blah. So when you come across an issue, I'm right there. We get through it, keep it moving.
Wise words of encouragement. Let's go.
I told him when we finished the conversation, I went back, woke his ass up, and I told him, I want to leave you with these words. That's when I told him, the people you know, at the stage they're at, what level are they at? You're fucking at the top of your game. Know that. you're the shit. Dwell on that.
Fuck, we didn't take the sign off.
The quicker you realize it, quicker we're gonna get to those millions. We're talking about Nicaragua. Basically, history repeats itself. This time it's coming with a fucking bang. Killing the competition.
That's all, folks.
Biggest risk you take is not taking one. So in these times, you got to be ready to take risk. You got to be ready to feel uncomfortable, because that's what makes you create solutions.
Let's get it. Hop off a 16 passenger. This is D5. I know this not a challenger. I get some members with me in the freeze. Get cold seat.
Bro, he's smarter man than me. The pitcher, he knows better.